तो हेलो एवरीवन, इफ यू ऑल कैन हियर मी जस्ट राइट अ यस। इफ यू ऑल कैन हियर मी एंड इफ यू कैन सी द स्क्रीन, जस्ट राइट अ यस इन द चैट बॉक्स सो दैट वी कैन स्टार्ट। यू कैन राइट अ यस सो दैट वी कैन स्टार्ट। ओके, so we'll start from the select query now. Last class we saw what are the good practices of coding. So now we are actually starting to write, and we have also seen a lot of codes, right? Now actually we will start using a big data set. So we'll use an employee data set, and we'll use select command, select query. Select is a very, very important query which you will see in SQL. So if you use SQL anywhere, any day future in your life, you will have to use the select query every day. If you use MySQL, then trust me, select is one query which you will always have to use, and this is the most important query. Okay, so now so let's start. Till now we have studied about the theory of relational databases, okay? And then we have done about the SQL theory, creating SQL databases and tables, and we saw different SQL constraints like the primary key, the foreign key, unique key, null value, not null, unique, and all those were the different default. Those were the different constraints which we saw. Starting with the select command over here in this section, we will start with data manipulation. So we'll be given with a huge set of data, and we will try to manipulate that data using different queries. Okay, so the select statements allows us to extract a fraction of the entire data set. So suppose if you want to extract just a few columns, or maybe you just want to extract few rows. So how can you do that? You can do that using the select command, because we will now be dealing with thousands and millions of rows. Not only just talking about in thousands, but we'll also deal with 10,000s and millions of rows, because this is not possible in Excel, correct? Excel crashes if you try to add more than even 75 or 85,000 of rows. Used to retrieve data from the database objects like tables, and used to query data from a database. This is what we are going to do. So let's start with the select statement. I'm not going to, this is there in my PPT, but I'm not going to read the PPT entirely, and we'll start straight away. I hope you all have downloaded this employee data set. This employee data set, and you have executed the entire file, because this is very important for today's class. If you haven't done this, it'll take more than 5 minutes, or approximately 5 minutes, to run this entire file which you see over here. We've created a lot of tables, and we've created a lot of input rows over here. Okay, so we'll start. If you see here, I've already loaded, and here we have the employees data set. And when you just simply click on this employees data set, the button which you see over here, in the tables section, we see a lot of tables. So there is departments table, department employee, department manager, employees, salaries, and titles. So these are the 6 tables which we have. We'll try to manipulate these in our coming classes. So we'll be using this data set for maybe 3, 4 to 5 coming classes. Okay, so let's start with writing the very first query. Here I have the employee data set, and in the tables I have these many tables. So suppose I want to extract the name of the employees, the first name and the last name. You will see that in the employees table, in the columns section, you will see the first name and the last name. So I want to extract from the employee database, from the employees table, the first name and the last name columns. So how to do that? That is the first query which we are going to write. First we'll write select. Now let us start writing codes. As such, we are राइटिंग इट फॉर इन आर ऑफिस और इन आर कॉर्पोरेट्स, जनरली हमेशा ऐसा नहीं होगा दैट वील यूज़ द कैपिटल लेटर्स फॉर द कीवर्ड्स. सो वी विल ऑलवेज यूज़ दिस ब्यूटिफाई बटन विच वी सी ओवर हियर विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन आर लास्ट क्लास. एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर द शॉर्टकट वॉज कंट्रोल बी. आई हैव ऑल्सो मेड अ लिस्ट ऑफ द इंटायर शॉर्टकट्स विच आई शो यू ऑल विच यू कैन यूज इन फ्यूचर. ठीक है, सो हियर आई एम राइटिंग सिलेक्ट. And what do I need to select? I need to select the first name and the last name. So I'll write first name, comma, last name. And from where do I want to select it? So let me first go to the PPT and show you all how the command goes. Select whatever the columns you want to select, column 1, column 2, dot, 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 column n, from the table name. You need to specify the table name as well. Okay, so we will start writing this. Before this, SQL should know that we are talking about which data set, the employees data set, because you can see we have sales data set as well. So I need to write use employees. This is a very important line which I have to give, use employees. Correct, and I execute the statement use employees. Now I can select the first name and the last name from employees table. This is the name of the table. Okay, this is the name of the table. I will select the entire thing. I can click on run execute button, or what I can do is I can just keep my cursor over here and click on this button so that it executes only this particular command and not all the commands. See what it did? It returned this entire table. First name, last name, this is the employees table. You can see employees table, and these are the different name of the employees which we have. You can see there is a lot of name of the employees which we have over here. Is it clear? Now to make it better, what we can do is we can select the entire command, because as I said, we'll not always use the capital select capital from. So what we can do, we can click on this beautify button over here. The moment we do this, you can see it has turned our code into perfect alignment, and everything is there. The keywords has been changed into capital letters. These have sent into a new line. So this is how we generally write our codes. We write it in the very same line, and then we use the beautify button, or we click on control B, which is the shortcut. Is it clear? Please, I am giving you all the time. Do execute this command and let me know whether you are getting your answer or not. Just type a yes in the comment section whether you're getting this answer or not. So I'm waiting for you all to do it. If you all are not doing along with me, you can just write, no, I'm not doing along with you, so that I know and I can proceed. Okay, so let's move on. This was the first name and the last name which we extracted from the employees table. Now suppose I want to extract all the columns from the employees table. How do we do that? Again, we have a shortcut for that, or you can say wildcards, which we are going to study later on in this class itself. Select star from employees. See, I'm writing it in the first line, in one line itself. I'm not using two lines because I know I can use the beautify button to set it correct. So I'll just give cross this and I'll see select star from employees. What does this star represent? This is a wildcard. What is a wildcard? We'll be talking about this. This is basically to select all the columns from the all the columns, all the rows from the employees table. From this employees, which you see over here, employees table. So let me execute this. And see, we have all the columns, employee number, birth date, first name, last name, gender, and hire date. So we have all the columns and we have all the rows. Clear? I can click on the beautify button to get it beautifully in different lines with capital letter keywords. It's fine. Now we can move to our next portion. This was where I selected all the columns, or maybe the first name and the last name. You can give the column names which you want to select simply in separated by commas, and then you can just give this star sign to extract all the columns at once. To extract all the columns at once. This tab which we get over here is called the result grid. Here we get the result of whatever we execute over here. The codes which we execute over here, the result is shown here. And here you can see there are 1,000 rows which are there in the employees table. Here is the action output, whether your code was executed properly or not, where there whether there was any warning or not, whether the duration was, what was the duration for the code, and so on. Okay, so let's move on to the next one. Just give me a thumbs up or yes if you all are clear with the select from. We can then move to select from where clause. Next, we'll do the where clause. So just give me a thumbs up or yes if this is fine with you and we can move ahead. Just give me a thumbs up if you have done this or maybe you have understood, and we can move on to the next one. Okay, so let's move on to the next, which is the where clause. Now, what is the where clause? Where clause is basically, suppose I want to extract the first name and the last name column. And I want to extract only those rows based on a certain criteria. Maybe the first name should be Dennis. The first name should be Dennis. So I have a few names over here in the table which were Dennis. So maybe the first name is Dennis, which I want to extract. Or maybe anything else is what I want to extract. So what I will do, I will pass a condition. I have to give a condition that I need to extract only first name column, or maybe all the columns you want to extract where the first name is Dennis. Okay, so again we'll write a code like this. I'll write select. What do you need to select? I need to select all the columns from where do I want to select it? From employees table. And what is your condition? My condition is where, let me write it in the second line, from, so that it's useful and it's understandable. Okay. Where the first name is Dennis. So I need to write Dennis. Again, as I said, my SQL is not case sensitive, so I can use capital D, small d, doesn't matter. Correct? Dennis, and I give a semicolon to end the statement. So what I've written, select all the columns from the employees table where the first name is Dennis. There the first name is Dennis. This was select from, this is your where clause. Okay, so now let me run this. I need to write a capital S over here, employees, and then let me just run this. So it took 0.797 seconds to extract this entire output, where the first name you can see is only Dennis. See, you can only see in the first name column, Dennis is only there. And how many rows I've got? I've got 232 rows are affected. I've got 232 rows out of 1,000 rows. 232 rows are people whose first name is Dennis. 232 people, 232 employees are there whose first name is Dennis. This was your where clause, where you give any particular kind of a condition that you want to extract it on a based of a certain condition. You can give any other name and you can check whether you're getting exactly this or not. I've got all the columns where the first name is only Dennis. Where the first name is only Dennis. Now suppose if I want to use or if I want to give more than one criteria. If I want to give more than one criteria or more than one conditions, then I need to use another operator or a clause which we'll see, which is your AND clause. AND clause. This is basically, we call this as an operator. Why? Because I am connecting two conditions. I am connecting two conditions. So what do I write over here? Again, I will give the same statement. Let me go to the PPT and show you all. So what are the operators in SQL? There are many linking keywords and symbols called operators that we can use along with the where clause. These are AND, OR, IN, NOT IN, like. So we are going to see all of these operators in our coming classes. In this class itself, we will see a lot of it. Basically, what I'm trying to say is that when you want to put more than one condition. So here, if you can see, I've used an equal operator. I've used an equal sign. First name equal to Dennis. So I've used a equal operator over here. So this equal operator which you see is again called a sign or again called an operator. Why? Because I am trying to put a condition. I am trying to put a condition that first name should be equal to Dennis. First name should be equal to Dennis. Now we'll start with the AND clause. AND clause is again kind of similar to your equal to sign, equal to operator which you see over here. But here we can use more than one conditions together. Suppose my two conditions are, let me write the two conditions. Suppose my two conditions are that the first name should be Dennis. And I want, and if you can see in the gender section, we have Dennis both who are male and female. So first name Dennis is both male, is for both male and female. So I only want male. I only want male. So what do I do? Again, I write select. I can here use the beautify thing. You can avoid it if you want to, or if you want to, you can use it. It's better that you use the modify shortcut, which is your control B. So select. I want to select everything. Select star from employees where what? Where the first name should be equal to Dennis, and I give an AND operator, and gender should be equal to male. Now again, I can give double quotes, I can give single quotes, doesn't matter. It takes to be the same, it is taken as same in MySQL. If you give single quotes, if you give double quotes, if you write capital letter M, if you write small letter M, doesn't matter. It will give you the same thing. So what I'm doing, I'm saying and. Here we have 230 rows with all the first name as Dennis, both male and female. Here I'm using and operator, which means I want the first name as Dennis and the gender as to be male only. So obviously the output of this will have lesser number of rows than 232, because in this case we have both male and females. Here in this case I just want male. So let me execute this and check. So see, it returned 140 rows. It returned 140 rows, and you can see we have Dennis and male. So what is basically and? And is when your all the conditions are satisfied, I then want to return that particular column, that particular row. So if you want to add more conditions to it, you can again write a and over here and give another condition which you want to. Is it clear? It's very simple. It's basically you want to extract only those rows whose first name is Dennis and the gender is male, and the gender is male. So both the conditions should be specified, then only I will get that particular row. As you can see, I'm getting both the conditions satisfied, Dennis and male. Clear? Now next, we'll go to OR operator. OR operator, just similar to that of your AND operator, AND clause, we have the OR operator. Now what is OR operator? Basically, again, I can pass more than one conditions. So let me now give another condition. I want two first names, Dennis and Elvis. Dennis and Elvis. So I will say select star from employees where first name is Dennis and, not and, or first name Elvis. First name Elvis. And let me run this and check what happens. So see, I've got 478 rows where I have both Elvis and Dennis as the first name. Elvis and Dennis as the first name. What does this OR means? Basically, it is a summation. Basically, it can be treated as a summation. I want all those first names, all those columns and all those rows whose first name is Dennis or first name is Elvis. So it can be both. It can be Dennis also. It can be Elvis also. If I write and over here, how many rows will I get? Let's check. Let's write a and over here and check. Running this, I'm getting zero rows. Why do I get zero rows? Because obviously it is not possible that the first name can be both Dennis and Elvis. This is not possible. Either it can be Dennis only or it can be Elvis only. So you cannot write and. This and means the first name should be both Dennis and Elvis, which is obviously not at all logical. So it's clear. Now, there is something called operator precedence. So we have seen the AND operator where it allows to logically combine two statements, allows us to narrow the output. Why narrow the output? Because see over here, for first name as Dennis, we were getting 232 rows. But when I put the condition as it has to be Dennis and the gender has to be male, when this was my condition, then I was getting only 140 rows. So it helped me to narrow down my output. From 232 rows, I'm getting just 140 rows with first name as Dennis and gender as male. Okay, so it allowed me to narrow down my output. This happens usually when you want to extract niche type of data. What do I mean by niche data? Where I am totally focusing on people with first name Dennis and gender male. And I can also then more elaborate, and I can say the birth date should fall between 1990, the employee number should be in thousands, and all of these we'll see in this particular class only. Clear, it helps me narrow down the data. Next we have the OR, which in which we saw that it allows to, it conditions the set on the same columns. So basically what it is saying that condition sets on the same columns, and in the AND operator you can set the conditions for different columns. In case of OR, you have to set it in one column itself. You have to set it for the one column itself. What does this mean? This means that here you can see the difference. Let me remove this, or let me just comment down this thing. So let me just comment down this thing. Okay, so here if you can see the difference between the OR and operator. So the difference is, in case of AND operator, I apply two conditions. The first name should be Dennis and the gender should be M. Now this can be applied to two different columns. But in case of OR operator, you need to apply it only on the one column itself. So if you are saying that first name can be Dennis or the first name can be Elvis. Otherwise there is no meaning. Otherwise there is no meaning, because if you say first name Dennis or gender male, that means that I want Dennis and I want everyone else with gender male and female. So here then I will get basically all the rows. I will get all the thousand rows. I will get all the thousand rows in that case. In that case, I will get all the thousand rows. Why I will get all the thousand rows? Because I'll be saying first name Dennis or gender male, which means first name should be Dennis or the gender can be male or female, both. So basically, I'll get everyone whose first name is Dennis. Along with that, I will get everyone whose gender is male and female. So obviously, I'm getting all the rows. Obviously, I'm getting all the rows. So that does not hold any meaning. So with AND operator, we can use two different, more than two columns. With OR operator, we generally always use it on one column itself, where the first name is Dennis or first name is Elvis. Clear? We generally use it with only one column. Now there is something called operator precedence. Suppose I am writing a code where I have both OR and operator. OR AND operator. So let me check this. If I write operator precedence, in this case, suppose I am writing, let me copy paste this particular code. Select star from employees, and let me give a statement where last name. So suppose, let me first give the condition. So the condition is, I want all Dennis who are male, or Dennis who are male, plus I want other females as well. So basically, what is my condition? My condition is, I want all the Dennises, all the first name, all the employees whose first name is Dennis, who are male, and all the females. and all other females. This is my condition. If this is my condition, let's just suppose, let me write this code, the first name, not the last name, the first name. The first name is equal to Dennis. The first name is Dennis, and gender is male, or gender is female. This is my entire code. Select all the rows from employees table where the first name is Dennis and the gender is male. This is what I wanted. This is what I wanted. Or gender is female. Or gender is female. So now let me run this and check what is happening. So I'm getting the output where I have first name, where I have the first name. You can see I've got all the rows where the gender is female only. I've not got any single thing where the gender is male. Everywhere you see the gender is female. Everywhere the gender is female. Everywhere the gender is female. Now let me run this again and check. See, everywhere we get gender as female. So I am giving you all 2 minutes time to understand and reply to me that why is this happening. To just understand why is this happening. The first name is Dennis and the gender M and gender female. Why is this happening? I'm giving you all 2 minutes time to understand and tell me. So basically what has happened, if you have realized that I have not got anyone with the first name as Dennis. I've got all the 1,000 rows over here. I've got all the 1,000 rows over here. Because the first name is Dennis. Now there is something as operator precedence. In that case, what happens? The AND operator precedes over the OR operator. That means your AND operator is greater than the OR operator. What does this mean? This means that in any statement where you write both the AND and the OR operator, then the AND operator will take the precedence. The AND operator will take the precedence. What does this mean? That this entire thing, the one which I've highlighted, this entire thing, first name Dennis and gender male, this entire thing will be taken as the one condition, the first condition, and this entire thing will be taken as the other condition. So basically this plus this is what exactly happening, and I'm getting all the 1,000 rows. So I'm getting people whose first name is Dennis and gender is male. And also plus also I'm getting people whose employee whose gender is female. Iska matlab kya hai? Iska ye matlab hai ki jab aapka first name Dennis hai and gender male hai, so I'm getting only those rows jahan pe first name is Dennis and the last name and the gender is male. As I did earlier where I got I think 140 rows. Theek hai? So ye mera output aaya. उसी के साथ और मुझे क्या चाहिए? और मुझे चाहिए जेंडर फीमेल, और मुझे क्या चाहिए जेंडर फीमेल. दिस इज वॉट इज हैपनिंग ओवर हियर. आई एम गेटिंग ऑल डेनिस हुआ मेल प्लस आई एम गेटिंग ऑल द एम्प्लॉयज हुआ फीमेल. सो बेसिकली आई एम गेटिंग ऑल द डेटा ना, क्योंकि डेनिस जो मेल है वो आ जाएंगे. बाकी व्हेन आई एम सेइंग और जेंडर इक्वल टू फीमेल, व्हेन आई एम सेइंग दिस, दिस मीन्स दैट इनको छोड़ के बाकी जितने भी फीमेल्स हैं, तो इसमें डेनिस हुआ फीमेल्स वो भी आ गए एंड अदर फीमेल्स दे ऑल्सो हैव कम इन दिस. ऑल अदर फीमेल्स दे हैव ऑल्सो कम इन दिस. क्लियर? क्लियर? नाउ सपोज इफ आई tweak this code a little, if I tweak this code a little and I write this and I write this, so what I'm doing, I'm saying that the first name is Dennis and the gender is male and female. So basically here I will get all the first name who is Dennis, who are Dennis, and the gender can be male or female. So now let me run this and check. So here I'm getting again 232 rows. This is again 232 rows, which is exactly same as writing first name equal to Dennis, because this then does not hold any meaning because both gender is only taking two values, male and female. So are you understanding the difference? जब मैं बोलती हूँ ऑपरेटर प्रेसिडेंस, जब हम लोग एंड एंड और दोनों ऑपरेटर साथ में लेते हैं, देन ऑलवेज एंड हैज़ अ प्रेसिडेंस ओवर द और ऑपरेटर. इन दिस केस व्हाट हैपेंड, फर्स्ट नेम एंड जेंडर मेल, ये पूरा एक सेट बन गया. सो आई गॉट फर्स्ट नेम हुज जेंडर वॉज मेल एंड देन आई गॉट हुज जेंडर वॉज फीमेल. सो इस केस में बाकी सारे फीमेल्स आ गए. Is it clear what I'm talking? बाकी सारे females आ गए. But I wanted, in this case what is happening, I'll show you. In the second case, all Dennis who are both male and female. In this case, I meant all Dennis who are both male and female. So first name Dennis and this. So this is one condition and this is the other condition. So the first name is Dennis and the gender is male and female. These are the two conditions. Condition one, condition two. And in this case, this is the one condition. You can highlight it. This is the one condition, first name Dennis, gender male, and this is the other condition where we get gender female, where we get the gender as female. So this plus this entire thing, yahan pe, this is the first condition, this is the other condition. So these are two conditions and this is what the and or operator does. Now, the logical order with which we must comply when we use both operators in the same where block. Logical operator precedence, an SQL rule stating that in the execution of the query, and operator is applied first, or operator is applied second. Regardless of the order in which we use these operators, SQL will always start by reading the and operator first. It will always start by reading the conditions around the AND operator. So this line is very important. You can highlight this line. This line says that reading the conditions around the AND operator first. It will always start by reading the conditions around the AND operator first. This means that in this case, yahan pe, it read and operator yahan pe hai, or operator yahan pe, doesn't matter ki kiska position kidhar hai. Yahan pe it read this as, pehle ye wala pura and operator ke corresponding mein jo bhi conditions hai, first name Dennis, gender male, it read this first and then it read the other condition. This will always happen if you remove and from here and if you put it over here also, even if it is coming later than the or operator, whatever is there corresponding to the AND operator will be read first. So this will be read first. This will be read first and then this. In case where I want that no, these are the entire two conditions which I want to be read as AND. First name Dennis and gender should be male or female. So I give these parentheses or brackets. We call brackets ko we call parentheses in case of coding. Jabhi bhi, you've seen a lot of time I've used this word parenthesis. In VBA also I've used this a lot. Whenever we use brackets, whenever we say brackets, it means parenthesis. Or whenever we say parenthesis, it means brackets. Okay, it's same. But generally, it's a coding thing that we use the word parenthesis. Okay. Is it clear? Now, can we move to the next one? Now, can we move to the next one? So the next operator which we have is the IN operator. Is the IN and NOT IN operator. IN, NOT IN. IN and NOT IN operators. So suppose I want people with first name as Keti, Mark and Nathan. I want people with first name as Kathy, Nathan and Mark. This is what I want. So whatever we have done till now, just try to write a code with this particular condition. The condition says the first name should be Kathy, Nathan or Mark. The first name should be Kathy, Nathan or Mark. Try writing it on your own. Try writing it on your own. I'm giving you all 5 minutes time. or a no if you all can hear me. Please again just reply a yes or a no if I'm audible or not. So I was saying that select star from employees where your first name is Dennis. Not Dennis actually. Kathy. It has to be Nathan and Mark. So it can be either of three. So I'll be using the OR operator. First name, Nathan, or the first name, Mark. Okay, let me run this and check. So see, I'm getting all the first name, where the first name is Nathan, Mark, Katie. These are the three names I'm getting, and I'm getting 691 rows. Now, instead of writing it in this way, what else I can do? How can I simplify this code? There is something called as in operator. So if I say that where first name is nothing but Kathy, Nathan, and we had Mark. Now see, so basically what is happening now, I'm saying that where the first name is either Kathy or Nathan or Mark. So first name can be anything within these parentheses. Clear? Now let me run this and check. See, again I'm getting the same output, 691 rows. But can you see one difference? That here the time taken is also different. Let me run this again and check. If I'm running it this, select star from employees where first name is Kathy or first name is Nathan or first name is Mark, and I'm running this. So it took me 281 seconds. Now if I'm running this, it took 234 seconds. So it took a less of a time. Iska matlab ki if we use the in operator, it will take less time. First name is either Kathy, Nathan or Mark. Clear? In teenon mein se koi bhi ek ho sakta hai. We have used the in operator and in the brackets have specified all the conditions. So ye again, this acts as a OR operator only. And OR operator mein we had a condition ki aapko khali ek hi column pe usko apply karna hai. So we are applying it only on the one column, which is the first name. We are applying it on the one column itself, which is first name. Now suppose I write the second operator, which is not in. Let me check what happens. As the name suggests, select all the rows from employees where the first name is not Kathy, not Nathan, not Mark. Now let me run this. So see, I've got all the rows, because this, you can see, I've got all rows where you will not get the name as Nathan, you will not get the name as Kathy or Mark. Clear? I'm just getting those first names who are not Katie, not Nathan, not Mark. I'm getting 1,000 rows. Actually, I've set the limit over here as 1,000 by default. Let me set the limit as 2,000 and check. See, I'm getting all. So there are actually n number of rows. If you see in the employee database over here, which you have run, there is more than 42,000 rows, which you can see. More than 42,000. So now if we want to increase this, I've not done this because it's not required over here. But now let me set it as maybe 5,000 and then run this. Okay, let me now set it as 10,000 and run it. See, all the 10,000. Because obviously I have 42,000 rows. I have 42,000 rows. I can increase the limit to 50,000 and check. All the 50,000. Increase the size and you will see that we will get the best way to check is you can simply scroll down and you can see there are no names. There are no names whose first name is Katie, Nathan or Mark. There are no employees whose first name is Nathan, Katie or Mark. So what is, this is obviously better than using your in operator, your or operator. If you want to put a lot of different conditions on the very first, on the very one column, but the first name should be Kathy, or it can be Nathan, or it can be Mark. So what I'm doing, I'm continuously putting the condition on this column itself, on one column itself. I can straight away write where first name is these three. The first name is any of these three. Clear? Clear? Next operator which we are going to deal with is like and not like. So again, this is very simple. Like and not like. So yahan pe ab aata hai bahut hi interesting portion. So let me select this, copy and paste. Now I want people whose first name is contains word or starts with mar. So if I say first name starts with Mar. In this case, what I'll do, where first name is like Mar. So what I'm trying to do over here, select all those rows, all those columns from employees whose first name is somewhat like Mar. Now, what is this percentage which I am giving over here? Let me go to the PPT and explain what are wildcards. We would need a wildcard character whenever we wish to put anything on its place. Yahan pe, it can be anything. Margaret, it can be Mark, it can be Marbelo, it can be anything. It should start with Mark and then it should start with M-A-R, Mar, and then it can be anything. So in place of anything, we use those wildcards. Now there are different types of wildcards which we do. Percentage, underscore and star. Percentage is a substitute of a sequence of characters. So if I say like Mar, over here M-A-R, Mar, and then I've given a percentage. It can be K, it can be Margaret, it can be Martin. It can be any number of letters, any number of characters. So when I use a percentage, it means any number of characters. Okay, so let me get this. So you can see I'm getting Mary, I'm getting Margaret, Marla, Mark, Mary, Marlo. So anything which starts with M-A-R. Anything which starts with M-A-R. Is it clear? Anything which starts with M-A-R. What is the percentage sign? The percentage sign means sequence of characters. It means more than one character. Now suppose if I use, again let me copy this. And suppose if I write instead of like this, if I want only those first names whose last two two characters is AR. AR. It can be anything in the starting, but in the last two, I want it to be AR. So again, I give a percentage AR and then I will execute this. This means anything in the start. At the end, I want it to be AR only. Let me execute this. See, I'm getting Otmar, Sukumar, Volkmar, Odwar. So these are Mukhtar, Manohar, so or Sridhar. So basically, I'm getting all those names of employees whose the last two letters is AR. Whose last two letters is AR. Last two letters are AR. Again, if I write it like this, if I write it like this, what does this means now? What does this means now? This means it starts with anything and it ends with anything. In between, it has to have AR. The first name can start with anything. It can end with anything. It can start with anything. It can end with anything. But in between, somewhere in between or somewhere within the first name, I want AR. I want AR together. I want AR together. Now let me run this and see. See, I'm getting Mary, Otmar, wherever you see that AR, Arif, even Arif. So there is nothing there in the starting, but at the end I have IF. Mary, Mukhtar. So wherever you see Hillary, you have AR. So wherever you have AR, Chikara, at the starting it can be anything, at the end it can be anything, but in between I want to have AR. And if I say it can be anything, it can be blank as well. It can be blank as well. So it might so happen that it is starting with AR. It might so happen that it is ending with AR. In this case, in this percentage sign, I have just nothing. Okay, so percentage means a sequence of characters. If you're putting it at the end, it means it can end with anything. If you're putting it at the start, it can start with anything. If you're putting it at the both the sides, it means it can start with anything, it can end with anything. It might so happen that it can be blank as well. It can be blank as well. Now suppose I want a single character. I want a single character. I want it to be Mark or Mary, which means it should start with MAR. The first name should start with MAR, but it can end with any character. But it can end with any character. It has to start with MAR, but it can end with any character. So I give a underscore. I give a underscore. It has to start with MAR, but it has to only end with one character, either Mark or Mary or anything, just like that. See, Mark, Mary, Marl, Mara, Mart. I have all these names whose first name is starting with MAR, but it is only ending with one character. So when I use the wildcard underscore, it means it matches with a single character. If I write Mar, it can be Mark, it can be Mary, it can be Marv, it can be anything. It has to only end with a single character. Here, percentage means it can be anything more than one character, or one character, or more than one character. When you want just a single character, then you use the underscore. We've already seen what does the star represents. It delivers all the columns in this particular code. Select all the columns from employees. It can be used to count all the rows of the table as well, which we'll see in future. So basically, I'm selecting all the columns from the employees table. I'm selecting all the columns from the employees table. Clear? So this was like the first name has to be somewhat like it should start with MAR. It can end with any single character. This is your like operator. What is your not like operator? What is your not like operator? Let me check. Not like, and then maybe I'm giving a percentage over here and a percentage over here. This means the first name should not have any sequence as MAR in between. The first name should not have any characters as MAR, either ending with MAR or starting with MAR or MAR in between. It should not contain MAR as the sequence of characters. It should not either start with it or end with it or be in middle. So I will select and run this, and you see you will not get a single name over here. You will not get a single name over here whose name is starting with either MAR or ending with MAR, or in between the name you're getting MAR together. There is not a single name with MAR, because I've said the first name should not be like this. Should not be like this. Again, it is case sensitive, so you can write it as capital MAR, or you can write it entirely as small MAR, or you can write it as capital MAR. It can be anything, because this is case insensitive. It is case insensitive. So this means that it doesn't matter that whether you're using caps lock or not. Okay, now I'm giving you one question to do. I want all the employees who were hired in year 2000. This is your first question, and your second question is extract all the employees whose employee number is of five characters and it starts with 1000. This is what I want you all to do. These are the two questions which I have given you. All the employees hired in year 2000, this is the hire date. This is the hire date. And all the employees whose employee number is of five characters, which starts with 1000. So these are the two things which you have to do. And then we'll move on to the next set of clauses. So I need all the employees who were hired in year 2000. So this is very simple, not to worry at all. This is the basic code which I'll need. Select all columns from employees where your hire date is somewhat like, it has to be of 2000, it has to be 2000, so percentage 2000, percentage it can start with anything, it can be end, it can end with anything, but it should have the, it should have this 2000. The starting should be your 2000. The year should be your 2000. Let me run this and check. See, I'm getting all those employees whose hire date is 2000. Whose hire date is 2000. Only 13 employees. Only 13 such employees whose hire date is 2000. Whose hire date is 2000. Clear? Clear? Whose hire date is 2000. Now I want those employees whose employee number is of only 5 characters but it starts with 1000. Is only 5 characters but starts with 1000. So how it should be? It should be employee number like, it should start, as I said, it should start with 1000. It should start with 1000. But only 5 character means it only has 5 characters. Matlab, it should end with only 1 character. So I will give a semicolon. I will give a underscore. I will give a underscore. It should start with 1000. So it started with 1000. And then it should only have 5 characters, which means it should end with an underscore, which means it should only have only one character after 1000. Let me run this. See, I'm getting only those employees whose employee number is 1, and I'm getting 9 such rows, 1001, 1002, and so on, and so on. Next we have between and. Suppose I want all those employees whose hire date, who were hired between 1st January 1990, who were hired between 1st January 1990 and 1st January 2000. So what do I do? So I'm starting with between and, let me select this. Hire date should be between, as I said. So first we write year, month, 1st January 1990, and 1st January 2000. So year, month, date. See? The hire date should be between 1st January 1990 and 1st January 2000. See? It is only, I've got 1000 rows where the hire date is between 1st January 1990. So now again, also very important thing which you should know is that even 1st January 1990 and 1st January 2000 is included. So I will get a higher date which can be 1st January 1990. These are included when I want a condition between these two. These two values are also included. If I write not between, so I will get all those employees whose higher date is not between 1st January 1990 and 1st January 2000. Let me give you an example to do. I want all those employees whose department number is between D003 and D006. So it is basically to select all the columns from employees where the department number so where is the department number coming from? This can be found in other tables. Maybe let us check where will I get the department number. I'm getting the department number in department manager. Okay. So I will use the department employee table. I will use the department employee table wherein I have the department number. So from which table? From the department employee table. In this table, I have the employee number and the department number. So I can take from the department. The table name is department employee. See, this is the name of the table, department employee. And within that, the department number should be between D003 and D006. Are you getting it? Because I do not have any department number in this employees table. I have it in the department employee table where I will get all the employee numbers. Whose department number is between D003 and D006, which means I will get all those employees with department number D003, D004, D005 and D006. So now let me run this and check. See, I'm getting all those department whose only department number is 003, 004, 005 and 006. So if you scroll down, you will get 004, 005 and 006 as well. Is it clear? Next we have is not null. Now basically, why do we use this? Let me go to the PPT. Not between, I've seen again, not between, we have done. The hire date before and after this is not included. It can be used for date values. It could also be applied to strings and to numbers. And we have used the department D003 and D006. So I've got all the employees whose employee number was between D003 and D006. Next we have is not null. Suppose I want to extract those values from a particular column whose values are not null. So now let me check. I will write select star from employees where the first name is not null. I want all the name of the employees, all the rows in which the first name is not null. Let me run this and check. So I've got all the values where the first name is not null. If I want those columns or those rows whose first name is null, so I will write is null. Select all the rows whose first name is null. Let me check. Zero. So can you understand that I do not have any single row where the first name is null. मतलब कि मेरे डेटा में ऐसा एक भी रो नहीं है जहाँ पे फर्स्ट नेम नल का वैल्यू ले. यानी कि आई हैव अ फैंटास्टिक डेटा सेट. जनरली ऐसा होता है कि हमारे डेटा सेट में कुछ नल वैल्यूज़, कुछ ब्लैंक वैल्यूज़, मिसिंग वैल्यूज़ होते हैं जो हम लोग आगे करेंगे. बट इन दिस डेटा सेट आई हैव अ मैग्निफिसेंट, आई हैव अ अमेजिंग फैंटास्टिक डेटा बेस, क्योंकि ऐसा कोई डेटा बेस नहीं होता जिसमें नल वैल्यू नहीं है. यहाँ पे मेरे पास ऐसा डेटा बेस है जहाँ पे जिसमें एक भी फर्स्ट नेम नल वैल्यू नहीं ले रहा, एक भी फर्स्ट नेम नल वैल्यू नहीं ले रहा. क्लियर? सो लेट अस टेक अ क्विक रिविजन ऑफ टूडेज क्लास, वॉट वी हैव डन. जस्ट अ क्विक ओवरव्यू ऑफ द एंटायर क्लास. We started with the select query, select from. Suppose I want to select the first name and the last name columns from the employees table, the column names and then the table name. Then I want to select all the columns from the employees table. Now, if I want to select only those rows on basis of a certain condition, so what I say, I want to select all the columns. This is for the columns. I want to select all the columns from the employees table where the first name is Dennis. This is my condition. Where ke baad I apply the condition. Theek hai? Agar aapko do conditions saath mein dalne ho, to we'll have to use the AND or the OR operator. Yahan pe, suppose I want the first name to be Dennis and the gender to be male. दोनों कंडीशन सेटिस्फाई होंगे तभी मुझे फाइनल आउटपुट मिलेगा. सपोज आई वॉन्ट द फर्स्ट नेम टू बी डेनिस और इट कैन बी एल्विस. और ऑपरेटर में हमेशा वी अप्लाई इट ऑन अ सिंगल कॉलम. वी अप्लाई इट ऑन अ सिंगल कॉलम. इन केस ऑफ एंड ऑपरेटर वी कैन अप्लाई इट इन बोथ द मोर देन वन कॉलम्स. ऑपरेटर प्रेसिडेंस में क्या होता है, हमने देखा जब भी हमारे पूरे स्टेटमेंट में वी हैव बोथ एंड और ऑपरेटर, and will take the first precedence. मतलब कि and के बगल में जितने भी commands होंगे उसको पहले read किया जाएगा. यानी कि this will be your condition one, first name Dennis and gender M, or gender female, or gender female. So पहला condition था कि Dennis होगा first name and gender हो जाएगा male. Second condition है कि gender होगा female. Clear? Now if I want ki nahi, ye pura as a one condition redo, this and this. So I will give the parenthesis, first name Dennis and the gender should be male and female. Which is same as getting the first name as Dennis. Theek hai? Yahan pe I am saying that the first name can be Kathy, Nathan or Mark. Instead of doing it this way, humne kya use kiya? In operator, jahan pe humne अपने सारे वैल्यूज को ब्रैकेट में डाल दिया. सो इट कैन बी आइदर के थी, क्योंकि ये सब कुछ खाली फर्स्ट नेम पे अप्लाई हो रहा है, एक ही कॉलम पे अप्लाई हो रहा है. जब एक ही कॉलम पे अप्लाई होगा तो आप ऐसे करके डाल सकते हो. सिमिलरली नॉट इन, एकदम ऑपोजिट ऑफ इन. देन वी हैव लाइक नॉट लाइक, जहाँ पे हमने सारे वाइल्ड कार्ड्स किए कि फर्स्ट नेम कैन बी लाइक मार्क, इट शुड स्टार्ट विथ मार एम ए आर एंड देन इट कैन बी एंडिंग विथ एनी थिंग. इट कैन स्टार्ट विथ एनी थिंग, इट शुड एंड विथ ए आर. इट कैन स्टार्ट विथ एनी थिंग, एंड कैन एंड विथ एनी थिंग, बट इन बिटवीन इट शुड हैव ए आर. यहाँ पे इट शुड एंड विथ ओनली अ सिंगल कैरेक्टर. ठीक है? वी कैन डू इट फॉर नंबर्स एज वेल. जहाँ पे मैंने 2000 निकाला, वी कैन डू इट विथ स्ट्रिंग्स एज वेल. एंड यहाँ पे मैंने एक और एग्जाम्पल लिया, बिटवीन हायर डेट शुड बी 1st January 1990 और 1st January 2000, जहाँ पे ये दोनों भी इंक्लूड होगा. ठीक है? नॉट बिटवीन मतलब कि आई विल नॉट गेट एनी हायर डेट बिटवीन दीज टू, और 1st January 1990 और 1st January 2000 और इसके पहले का या इसके बाद का कोई भी मुझे हायर डेट नहीं मिलेगा. आई कैन डू इट फॉर द स्ट्रिंग्स एज वेल. नॉट नल, नल मतलब कि आई विल गेट ऑल द वैल्यूज विच आर नॉट नल, मतलब कि जिसमें वैल्यूज हैं, एंड आई विल गेट ऑल द वैल्यूज विच आर एक्चुअली नल. सो दिस इज टूडेज क्लास. टुमारो वील कम्प्लीट द सिलेक्ट क्वेरी, जहाँ पे हम लोग और भी करेंगे, बट सिलेक्ट क्वेरी इज समथिंग जो अब हम लोग डेली जब भी SQL करेंगे वील हैव टू यूज द सिलेक्ट कमांड. हमने क्या देखा, सिलेक्ट फ्रॉम वेयर, उसके साथ हमने क्या ऑपरेटर्स यूज किया, एंड और पैरेंथिस, लाइक नॉट लाइक बिटवीन एंड. इज नल नॉट नल. क्लियर है? तो इज नल एंड नॉट नल. थैंक यू.